to a carnival many years ago. No big deal, Ferris wheel, usual stuff, you know. I walked around the grounds till I found a little tent. Men outside gave a speech, and this is how it went. She walks, she talks, she crawls around on her belly like a reptile. Oh, it's the same old stuff, except for one part. He said it won't cost you no money. You got to pay with your heart. Oh, Sharon, what do you do to this man?
You know the same rowdy crowd that was here last night is back again.
Yeah. Of course, I went right inside and I searched around for a seat. The lights went low.
Tippy-toes.
Said a little bit of teeny-weeny tippy-toes. Big honking feet, but a little bit of tippy-toes. And she proceeded to entrechop, plie, pas de deux, and do-si-do across the stage like this. That spoke to something deep within her. She loved that part of the stage. No, I mean, she loved that part of the stage. Right there and then, in front of God and everybody. It was disgusting, it was. I loved it. She went like this, she went. She went like this. Thing for any woman to do, I want you to understand. Then she went like this. She went. this woman did something so amazing, something so manifestly extrapolatory, something so phenomenologically extraneous, something so municipally hirsute, that to this very moment in time, I doubt the evidence of my own oracular organs. Standing there alone upon the stage, at this point clad merely in one flimsy sneeze, having discarded the scarf ages ago, without saying a word, without making a sound, without uttering a noise, without a single audible, intelligible syllable issuing from betwixt those firm but pliant, moist, and oh, so inviting ruby red lips. It seemed to me as though the movements of her body were calling my name. She went like this, she went, she went, with the curly red hair. He had a big bushy beard and a build like a grizzly bear. He said, cease and desist from the demonstrations. That's a termination of the show. If you desire continuous respiration, turn around and go. I didn't hang out. I went straight to the door. On my way through, I heard that big bear roar. Oh, Sharon, what do you do? A couple steps ahead of that belligerent bear, and you know, it worked the way the man predicted in his speech at the start, because when that carny left town, it took a bunch of my heart, and I still get a pain to the tip of my bone every time I hear a bear play that Main Street song. Oh, what did you do to me?